Okay, so you're going to buy a sewing machine, but you don't really know if you actually need one of those expensive ones. Are the cheap ones just complete rubbish? What do you even look for? And do you really need all of those fancy stitches? So many questions, right? If we haven't met yet, my name is Evelyn Wood and I help new sewers just like you learn how to sew and how to create your own fabulous fashion. And today's video, I'm going to talk through my top three recommendations that I have when you're buying a new sewing machine. Okay, let's first talk about where you are in your sewing journey and what you should look for. For the very beginner, this is your first time sewing, your first machine, I actually recommend that you get a very inexpensive machine or a secondhand one. Vintage ones can work really nice. And use this just for about 6 months or however long until you really get into sewing and you're more confident and you really know that you want to continue with the hobby, because then you can really invest in a really good quality machine with more bells and whistles that will really up your sewing game from there. Tip number one when looking for a sewing machine is the weight of the machine. Now this is something that you could call the oomph test. Let me demonstrate this. When you pick it up, you should actually, it should feel heavy. Often these days they're replacing all the metal parts with plastic parts and therefore it makes it a lot lighter. Metal parts are great, is why vintage machines just keep working and working and working. And the other reason that you want a nice, heavy, sturdy machine is, although if you're just starting, you might be sewing quite slow right now, you will want to sew a lot faster and it will rattle around, and you shouldn't want, like, you don't want your machine to be moving around whilst you're sewing. Tip number two when looking for a sewing machine is you want to just use it and see whether you actually just like the feel of how the fabric goes through the machine. Now every machine is quite different, and just the way that it actually feeds through, the way it grabs it, it should feel nice. If it feels clunky and it just doesn't feel like you can maneuver it very well, you know, it's probably not the machine for you. Just get something that feels nice to sew with. And this is something that really only you can decide and see when you test run out several machines and see which you like the best of. Number three tip when looking for your sewing machine is the stitch selections. Let's be honest, there are only two stitches that you really need on your machine. That is your straight stitch, which is 90% of all sewing, and then a zigzag stitch. That is all that you need. So all you beginners out there thinking that you need a fancy machine to do all these bells and whistles and has all these fancy things on it, you don't need it. You just need a good straight stitch and a zigzag stitch, and that's it. Now the only other thing that you'll really want to look for when you upgrade, say, to your next machine, or if you're lucky enough to get it on your first machine, is a one-step buttonhole. Now this will be a lifesaver and will really up your sewing game when you can do buttonholes in a one step. You don't want to have to bother with all this three-step, move the fabric, move it around. I remember those days, it was horrible. I never did buttonholes until I got a one-step buttonhole. So that is definitely something that you want to look for. Might not be in your first machine because, let's be honest, you're probably not going to be going all the way into buttonholes just yet, but certainly once you've been sewing for a while, buttonholes are something that will really step up your sewing game and let you be more creative. So that's it. That's my top three recommendations for you when you're looking for to buy a sewing machine. And that's really all you need in a machine, is some basic stitches, and it should just feel comfortable. This will be more than enough to get you started on your sewing journey. And then, as I said, you can upgrade to a fancier machine with more bells and whistles after that. If you did like this video, please give me a thumbs up and leave me a comment below and let me know which of these tips has helped you the most to find your own sewing machine. I'd love to hear about it. Now, if you're new to sewing, I have something special for you. I have just launched a free 5-day crash course to learn to sew. You can find this on my website at evelynwood.com.au, and you can sign up and be part of this free program that I've got out to help you to learn how to use your machine and the basics of sewing. So thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye. Whoa. Yep, that's heavy. Ooh, it's definitely an oomph test.